this is good. This is very good for different reasons. And so I decided to keep both of them as a way to pick and choose what I wanted to do for my clients on any given day. Hi, my name is Chas. I've been a hairstylist in North Carolina for 14 years. And today I want to talk to you about dryers, okay? So let's get into it. The one we have a few dryers to talk about. I currently own a Babeless, a Dyson, and the Reprenizer. And I want to give you a rundown of all three. This is just a review video. I'm not going to be showing you all the differences. That will be a whole nother video. For one, with the Babeless Pro hair dryer, it's black. She has a Ferrari engine in her. I'm not even joking. That's what it says right on the packaging. I've had that blow dryer for about 7 years and it's fought a good fight. It's a good dryer. However, the technology in hair dryers is so much different now than it was 7 years ago, and nobody's talking about it. The Dyson came out and blew people's minds. Everyone is talking about the Dyson blow dryer and the Airwrap. I've never used the Airwrap. I'm still on the fence about whether or not to purchase one. However, I did get the Dyson blow dryer, and I'll show that to you. Okay, this is the Dyson blow dryer. This is how it comes. You're supposed to use these attachments. I didn't purchase the professional line one. The professional line one comes with an extra filter for down here. However, you're supposed to wipe this thing down after every use. I do it like once a day. I think that they say after every use specifically for people who blow dry their hair at home. There might be a lot of contaminants in the air at home. I feel like there would be more in the salon, probably why they have the extra filter. Anyway, I didn't get the professional one because the professional one didn't come in the color that I want, and I'm picky like that. Don't ask me why. I just don't like it when the colors don't match my very plain and beigey aesthetic. It has to be so neutral for me to enjoy it. Too much vibrance on my station feels like visual clutter. And so I tend to avoid anything like that. It distracts me from what I'm doing. We have the Dyson dryer. This is her in all of her glory. And since I didn't get the professional one, I didn't get this neat little mat that comes with it, but I did get other attachments that came with it. The diffuser, she pops on like this. Okay. This comb attachment, which, by the way, if you do extensions and you shampoo those extensions in the salon on your client's head, so let's say Susie comes in, you're shampooing her, she's got two rows of extensions, and you're like, dang, it's gonna take me forever to blow out these extensions. Use this attachment. Honestly, this dryer is worth it just for extensions, okay? Because when you pop this bad boy on, and she's got her natural beaded row or IBE or laced, whatever extension she has in, when you pop that in, it will send concentrated air to the top of that extension, and you can comb it through the hair and just continually push air where you need it instead of having a nozzle on or no nozzle on. And then you end up just like, this is taking forever, trying to really get the top of that weft. No, use the comb attachment. It will make your life so much more easy. And it will dry the hair so quickly. Trust me, okay? Then you have the scatter attachment. This one I never use, okay? I don't like this. This is just, I don't know. It's too messy. I want more control. So I use my regular nozzle and I use my comb attachment and my diffuser. So that's that for the Dyson. The Bay Bliss comes with maybe two or three nozzles and a diffuser, and the diffuser's fine, but because of the amount of power that's being pushed through on the engine, you can't get a soft diffuse unless you hold it several inches away from the head. But I really want to get a tighter placement for my diffuser so that way I can really ensure that the scalp and the zone one of the hair is getting super dry. I want to make sure that it is dry before the client leaves. Even if I let this soft set with like a partial dry out, I don't want my client's hair to be damp, you know? So I'll hold it away over down here where there's more of a curl pattern being exposed. However, up here, it needs to be right on the scalp. With the Bay Bliss dryer, if you were to do that, you would end up with a high amount of frizz and less control in this area. The Dyson lets you have more control. And especially if you use those flat clips, they're kind of like a updo clip. If you use those, it'll help. Now we're gonna get into super duper bougie dryers, okay? The newest one on the market right now is called the Reprenizer. It's by Lumalina, which is a Japanese line. And the entire reason why I'm doing this video, there was very little information about this dryer and I really wanted to share it with anybody who would be interested in listening. So for one, we have the Lumalina. It was something that I saw that was marketed on a lot of Instagrammers, hairstylist Instagrammers that I value their opinions. It was listed on their pages, and the Beauty Tech Distribution, the company that you purchase from, had a ton of stuff on their Instagram. However, Instagram tutorials don't really matter to me so much anymore. Sometimes I really want to see someone just be super honest and not give me like a 30-second blip. So this is me being honest. For one, your typical blowout time, if it is really, really, really long, then you're probably going to be okay with this, okay? It takes a long time to dry the hair with this. You don't just apply heat and that's it. The instructions say that you need to use the heat function and the cool shot function for similar amounts of time. And the way this is shown on Instagram is someone will blow dry a section. They'll have it mostly rough dried. Great, that's how I do it too. And then they go through section by section and will do heat and then switch it and do cool on that section and then put it down and move to the next section. And it seems like that is really not how we function with hair for the most part. We use heat, 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 and then maybe a cool shot at the very end of the service for just a few seconds. Like most of us are not even using the cool shot function. However, it does make the hair feel healthier and better and it looks shinier. I think that if you were to use it like they say to use it, it will take you double the amount of time to do the hair, to get the hair dried and the blowout complete. And that really doesn't make sense. Usually when you're ready for your finish work, you're not wanting to spend 30 to 40 minutes just on the styling process. You want to do it more quickly because you're not wanting to be inefficient with your time. Some people do have to take that amount of time. Some hair just dictates the amount of time. But if you have a fine-haired client that you've been able to blow dry in 5 minutes and suddenly it takes you 20, I know that's not double, but you feel the difference. You fatigue a little bit. So with this dryer, it takes longer to dry. They don't want you to call it a hairdryer. They want you to call it a beauty device, which I think is misleading. But they're trying to separate themselves from how people think of dryers in general. It is a completely different piece of technology. It works in the way that they want you to use it, the way that it's intended. But what I've understood about human behavior is that you can design something perfectly, but if you don't design it for the reality that is human behavior, it's not going to be used how you intended it. A on off button here. That's just a power supply button. These actually turn it on, and I'll give you an example. So I have this power button here. That just says that power is going to the dryer. These actually control the on off. This only controls the wind speed, okay? Only wind speed. You cannot control the heat. So we have one, two, three. To turn it off, you have to click that number again. However, when you're ready to do the cool shot function, let's say you've got it here, that there, and then temperature drops. I know you can't feel it, but the temperature drops tremendously. You turn it off. It's not exactly intuitive, and sometimes when I'm blow drying, because this is where my thumb rests, I hit this button a lot. It only comes with one nozzle, which is very frustrating. I think for the amount of money that it costs, they need to really send you with a set of nozzles, at least, you know, a comb attachment, a diffuser, and a concentrator. Seriously, that's standard for American dryers. But this is a Japanese dryer, so maybe things are a little bit different there. I'm not really sure what their consumer is purchasing. I have no market research in Japan. I watched the sales video that's available here on YouTube, and I can link it down below. And it's in Japanese, you have to read subtitles, and but it's a really sincere video, and I completely trust that this is not some sort of misleading marketing. It's good. It provides good information, and I would argue that I learned a lot more from that video than I did from watching Instagrammers talking about it, or Instagram stylists talking about it. Dyson, this is the on-off switch, and don't mind this. This is from where I just nest it into my holder. This is the on-off. This is a cool shot, which gets cooler but not cold. And then you have wind speed and heat function here. And as you see, it's a little bit, you have a little bit more control. I don't know if you can see that. You have three wind speeds, three heat speeds, and you can turn the heat off, and then you can turn it cold. I usually use number two, and then I'll use wind speed two and three, and sometimes one, depending. One is what I use for curly hair, for diffusing, and two I like to use when I need more time with the piece of hair before it sets and dries. So if I have a piece that I can't quite control perfectly, I need to take it down and slow down with that piece, and so that's why I use that. The on-off switch is super easy. I never accidentally hit anything. The design of this handle is very simple. I never hit something accidentally. Because you have to really pick and choose what you want to hit. You really do. So that was a great design. Dyson did a great job. Congratulations, Dyson. This is good. This is very good for different reasons. And so I decided to keep both of them as a way to pick and choose what I wanted to do for my clients on any given day. I like having options now, whereas early in my career, I thought, I just need to have one tool that does it all. Now I'm realizing that my tools need to be specific to my client, depending on what their needs are. And so I have a big collection of tools now, and some may criticize and say that that is unrealistic to have, and I agree completely, but unfortunately, there are so many different types of hair that I can't do the job that I want to do if I'm limited. And so I've come to the conclusion that I need to have an investment savings for tools specifically, so that way I can provide these tools for my clients and service them in the best way possible. This video has gone really, really long, and I'm gonna try to edit it down quite a bit, but I just wanted to tell you that when you're shopping for these items, it's really hard to find unbiased information, and I just wanted to share with you what my experience was with these items. I hope that you enjoyed this video, and I will be creating more like it, because I feel like there's not enough information about these tools, so just trying to help, okay? Check you later.